Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel. In today's video, we'll talk about kube-proxy, an important component of Kubernetes networking. Let's start with the basic. Kube-proxy is like a middleman that helps different services in Kubernetes cluster communicate with each other. In a Kubernetes cluster, every node has its own kube-proxy running. Kube-proxy can also forward different type of data stream like TCP, UDP, and SCTP. The kube-proxy component is responsible for implementing a virtual IP mechanism for the services, but other than the external name. The kube-proxy is set up in different modes like IP tables, IPvS, and kernel space for the Windows. But in this video, we focus on the IP table. Let's more deep on it. So, for example, consider we have a pod A and wants to connect to other pods. It can be backends or wants to connect to any pods. Here, for example, in this example, we have two pods, pod A and pod B, with the label of the proxy. And both of them point to the one service, that Nginx service, that's because we can see in the selector that they have the same label. So after we apply this code, it's going to create two pods and a service. When a service is created in the API servers, the virtual IP addresses are assigned to it. So for example, here, if we do the Kubernetes get kubectl get endpoint, we can see that now we have a one endpoint that points to the two pods. We can see in the endpoints the IP of the two pods. Then the API service notify the kube-proxy agents that's running on the each nodes. The one thing that we need to notice here that the kube-proxy also watch for the changes for the endpoint object, because it's going to check the, for example, pods readiness status or change the pods label change, because if the pod label change, so it's going to out of the scope of the service. So it can understand that these pods, actually the connection should be failed. Then each kube-proxy makes the service addressable on the nodes running on by setting up few IP tables rules, which make sure the packet is destined to the service. So if we SSH to the pods and check the IP tables command, for example, here I did the sudo IP tables in the NATS table and looking for the kube services list. Before the service created, I can see that there is a normal things with the kube system namespace, but later, when the endpoint's created, we can see another rule here that's point to the our services. That's the same destination IP as a service IP. But let's see if we do the curd command, how it's going to check the IP tables and how it's going to follow the rules here. Okay, if we execute in the pod A and do the curd command, the curl command send the HTTP request to the IP address, that's the IP of the service B on port 80. So the request is going to create a packet with the source and the destination IP of the service. It's going to request arrive at the host where the minikube is running, and the host IP tables are checking to how to handle the incoming traffic. The IP tables first check the kube services chain in the NAT table because the destination IP can found there. Then the IP table check the this name target here because it's a match with the destination IP. So we can see that in the IP table with the that destination name, here we can see that two rules for the each pod. The first rule is for the pod A, pod B, actually pod B, the one of them, and the second one for the pod B, the second one. Here we can see the static mode random probability 50%. it means that the 50% chance that traffic will be forwarded to the this bot. So if the traffic is directed to the first bot, the IP table is going to check this target. So if we check the this target, we can see that the rule here that's performed the destination NAT that's forward the traffic to the IP service and the port path. So it's going to change the packet. It's going to change a packet. It means that the source is the same, but now the destination is changed to the first pod. So it's going to the send pod to the first pod B. We can see it in the minikube too, the whole processes. Let's see it in the minikube. Okay, let's check the processes in the minikube. Now I'm in the machine that's container just one mode, and it's a minikube. Now let's first go to the minikube and SSH on it, and we can do the sudo the same command, sudo IP table and with the dash d net and the dash l, that's a kube dash services IP tables. Yeah, and here we can see that now we have only the kube system stuff and the default one in the kube services IP table in the minikube and for the IP table NATs. But let's see first create one pod. For example, here I can have a one beam pod service, so it's going to create the Nginx with the service Nginx, and there's a selector IP here, the selector label and point to the this label. So if I apply the this one, kubectl apply first the pod service, pod dash service. So if I check the pod here in the demo, the pod is running. If I check the service, I can see that, okay, now there's a service cluster IP, that's a service IP. If I check the endpoint, we can see that there is a one endpoint. Actually, it's a pod IP here. If I check the kubectl get pod dash wide, we can see that this IP, it's exactly here. But let's see what's changed here. If I do again, we can see actually kube-proxy, it goes to there and change this stuff here. So now we should looking for the service IP, this one. Yes, we can find it here. That's a target to the this rule, and we have a TCP anywhere this IP. So now if we check the this list, it should be just the one pod there. Yeah, exactly. We can see that one target here. That's point to the this IP. Now we can see that there isn't any chance of the 50% or this stuff. Let's if we check the other one here. Q. Okay, yeah, we can see that it's a last rule that's changed the packet. But let's apply the another pod. Like example that we saw, it's a pod Nginx. Let's see. Yeah, pod Nginx. It's just the create Nginx 2 with the same label for the service. So we don't need to change it. So apply. Now we're going to apply the pod dash Nginx. The Nginx, yes. Now if we check the pod, yeah, it's running with another IP. Now if we check the endpoint, that's interesting because now we should have two endpoints here. So the first one, actually nothing changed, but let's see again the target point that we did with the disservice. Okay, now we can see that here we have two rules. That's a 50% chance to go to which one. So if we send the packet once to the, it goes to the this rule, the second time goes to the this rule.